Thank you so much. Firstly, thank you for inviting me to be here and sharing some thoughts. I couldn't agree with more with Dr. Shamika that it's a national growth strategy we need at this point, and that pertains to textiles as well. Why our exports haven't reached where they should be is precisely because we lack this kind of a cohesive policy which ties together all the different parts of the value chain together and delivers the final export product in the best competitive way. In the best competitive way, in the best designs which are the demand of the export market. Because we have it all in our country, we have it better than any other country which is getting far ahead of us. We have the highest production of cotton and jute in the world. We are the second largest production of silk. And the textile sector is employing the second largest number of people after agriculture. It is a very solid base on which we can, if we get our strategy right, help this country to move towards the 5 trillion economy we are looking at. We have come in with schemes and incentives, but they are sporadic and too few and far between. And there is a lack of continuity and a strategy, as was mentioned. The people, the exporters, the business people, don't know what's going to happen next, if this is going to continue or be discontinued. We had a very good scheme, we still have it, the Technology Upgradation Fund scheme. This attracted a lot of investment. Over 2 lakh crore investment has been attracted through the scheme. And it has totally modernized the mill sector. But again, there has been interruptions, disruptions in the scheme. There's a huge backlog of subsidy in thousands of crores. So a business is, these are mostly small industries, are not able to sustain these kind of uncertainties which we introduce into the system. We also have, our schemes are good. We have a CTP, effluent treatment plant scheme, very, very important in the context of climate change also. But look at the dispersal compared to the outlays. It is very miserable, and that is so in all the schemes. So there has to be an improvement in the way we deliver our schemes, in some kind of a better conversation and participation of the private sector, both in planning and delivery of the schemes, so that the kind of delays and bottlenecks that are there don't happen. We also need a much greater push in design and reaching out to the sector, which is very widespread. And also the fact that we have different clusters working in different areas in our country. Spinning is confined to one part, weaving to another part, processing to another part. Now goods are traveling all over the country to get the finished product eventually. So that also reduces our competitiveness in a way. However, I would say the outlook for our market is very good. I've already mentioned the abundant raw material base, the low labor cost, and mind you, in China, with the rising labor costs, there's a whole market being vacated. There's a huge window of opportunity where India can cash in. We have the world's largest youth population. Our retailing is also picking up. You asked me specifically about export, but retailing here is a huge area where the textile industry faces a huge window of opportunity with a young and aspirational youth population. It is more into aspirational clothing. The young people all want the brands, and the Indian brands, therefore, need to develop much more. It's the foreign brands which are coming in now, sourcing from India and selling back to India and making money. So our own industry needs to get its act together on this. We have a very good social marketing network reach now. Our young population is picking up on the IT sector. So there is another opportunity there where our sector can cash in. So these are seen as the great markers and market drivers which are available for the textile industry, and we would do well to look at investment in this sector as a way to really boost our economy. Unfortunately, this is a sector which does not have very glamorous lobbyists behind it, as other industries do. So it lacks in focus as well as ability to project its needs and requirements.